Well, I recently got a new bike. Although I was pretty content with my 2017 Rocky Mountain Slayer, I felt it was time to try out the wagon wheels. After demoing several long travel 29ers, I decided on the Pivot Firebird 29, or as some like to call it, the Firechicken. This is a big bike. In addition to the 29-inch wheels, it's got 170mm of travel up front and 163mm of travel in the rear. This was one of my favorite bikes that I demoed in the Long Travel 29er shootout. The sizing felt just right, it should handle bike park days, pedaled up just fine, and it was fairly nimble on the descents. It really didn't feel like such a big bike until it hit some steep and rocky descents. I chose the Pro XD XDR kit. It comes with the Fox X2 shock and Fox 36 with Grip 2 fork. With the large amount of adjustability, it can take more time to get dialed in, but it's certainly one of the best suspension setups I've had. The fork is plush, but with still plenty of mid-stroke support. The brakes are the Shimano XTs with 4-piston calipers. So far, I've been really happy with these. Aside from the rattle from the finned pads, these brakes provide a noticeable improvement in modulation over the 2-piston XT brakes. It also came with the Shimano 11-speed drivetrain, an XT shifter, and XTR derailleur. It's an odd combination, but so far I have no complaints about it. You may be wondering why I didn't opt for the Eagle drivetrain. Well, the Shimano kit was $1,000 less, and to be honest, I was pretty happy with my 11-speed on the Slayer. The bars are the Phoenix Team low-rise carbon bars, which I left uncut at 800mm. Given the tight trails in my area, I may eventually cut them down to 780. I've kept the padlock grips, which I've found provide a ton of grip and are quite easy on the hands. I've replaced the stock stem cap with the K-Edge gravity cap mount for my Garmin Edge device. Though I've stripped the tiny screws on it twice and broken the holding clips on them, I still like the fact that it allows me to mount it cleanly to my steerer tube. The dropper is a KS Live SI with 150mm of drop. It's quick to rise and has performed flawlessly so far. However, given my relatively long legs, I may look at replacing it with a 170 to 180 dropper by 1UP Components. The WTB Pro High Tail Trail Saddle hasn't been the most comfortable, but with padded shorts, it's fairly tolerable. The rims are the DT Swiss M1700 laced to DT Swiss 350 hubs. The hubs are no i9s or Onyx in terms of engagement, but they are pretty solid, and best of all, they run fairly quietly. For tires, I'm running the Minion DHF 2.5 with EXO casing in the front. In the rear, I have an Assegai 2.5 with double down casing for enduro racing in rocky terrain. Though I'll switch this back to a DHR 2 2.4 with EXO casing for regular trail riding. Pedals? Well, I'm running the Crank Brothers Mallet DH clip-in pedals. They are fairly heavy, but after having a pair of carbon times blow up on a rock strike at the top of a mountain, I'm happy to make the weight sacrifice for a bit of more durability. So far, these pedals have taken quite a beating, and they're still going strong. If you're wondering what shoes I wear for these pedals, they're the 510 Kestrels, which recently replaced my Maltese Falcons. As you can see, I also carry a spare tube, CO2, and tire levers strapped to the frame. I've stuffed some zip ties into the crank as well. I also carry a 1UP Components 100cc pump with integrated toolkit, mounted to the bottle cage mount. You may be wondering what I do without a water bottle mount. Well, we'll cover that in a later episode. For now, be assured I stay well hydrated on those long hot summer rides. I've also fully wrapped the bike in bike protection from Bike Wrap, a company based in Whistler, BC. It came tailored exactly for my Firechicken and covered almost the entire frame. It was the first time installing bike protection for me, and while I can't say I did it quickly nor perfectly, it still looks pretty good, and the experience I got from it will help me for next time. So how does the Pivot Firebird 29 ride? Well, so far I've taken it to Panorama, Whistler, Silver Star bike parks, raced it in a couple of the Canadian Enduro races, ridden some of the double black slabs of Squamish and North Shore Jank, as well as my local trails. I can say with certainty that this is a fairly good do-it-all bike, and it has saved my butt a few times from poor line choices. While I'm still making minor adjustments to the suspension settings, the rear feels very plush over the rough stuff, but it doesn't quite feel as poppy as my Slayer. I'm still working on that. It's also an excellent climber, whether it's fire roads or technical rooty climbs. This has been the best climbing bike I've had to date. However, it's certainly no lightweight at 34.8 pounds with everything on it. I'm willing to make that sacrifice for its descending capabilities, and as a bonus, my legs will be strong and ready for ski season. I'm looking forward to pushing myself and the Firebird 29 into gnarlier terrain this season, and I look forward to providing you all with a long-term review in the coming months. If you enjoyed this video or found it helpful, please like and subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. As always, thanks for watching and ride on.